Well, pasteurization is a process that heats milk to a specific temperature for a set period of time. First developed by Louis Pasteur in 1864, pasteurization kills harmful organisms responsible for diseases like listeria, salmonella, typhoid fever, and diphtheria. But a recent movement is growing to go back to a more organic time of consuming raw milk straight from the cow. Joining me now is our Lisa Hines.
That's right, Rob. Many Oklahomans are choosing raw milk over store-bought pasteurized milk because they believe it keeps their families disease-free. But currently in Oklahoma, to buy raw milk, you have to drive to a farm, which can be several miles away. And many would like instead the convenience of having delivered right to your front door.
Milk. It does a body good. But there's a fight fermenting at the state capitol over the alabaster liquid. Representative Ken Walker is leading the way to change the current law regarding how raw milk is sold in Oklahoma.
There's a huge consumer base for raw milk, and the people want to have raw milk delivered to them. Some people do. Other people like the aspect of going to the farm. And there's some people who can't readily get out of their house. And so we were looking at three aspects today, and that was delivery from the farm to the consumer, herd shares, which basically would make you an owner of the cow and the transactions would be between owners, and thirdly, advertising of raw milk.
Edmond naturopathic doctor Michelle Menzel recommends raw milk to all her patients.
I love raw milk, and in fact, I think that it is safer than pasteurized milk because it still has all of the antibodies intact in the milk that actually protects the body from pathogens and assists the body in getting rid of things that the body doesn't need. So there's that protectant that is lost in the pasteurization process of commercial milk that you buy in the grocery store.
Joanna Francisco is a mom and believes in the benefits of giving her children raw milk.
We started to find resources out there. We found a dairy.
We have not had an illness in our family. We haven't been to the doctor in 7 years or more. And we have four children who have been raised on this basically, and they're just very healthy.
Yet some, like the State Department of Health's Mark Newman, advise prudence when consuming raw milk.
I think our concerns at the health department are that unpasteurized milk poses 150 times greater risk than pasteurized milk, and that the CDC, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, has documented over 1,500 cases of foodborne illness from people from consuming unpasteurized milk or unpasteurized milk products between 1993 and 2006. And we just know from the experience that other states have had, which have relaxed their laws on raw milk and raw milk products, that you're going to see an increased incidence of foodborne illness from the consumption of raw milk.
According to Blaine Arthur from the Oklahoma Department of Agriculture, Food and Forestry, they just want to be sure that the public is aware of the raw milk issues.
We want to make certain that for any consumers who are making the decision to purchase raw milk for themselves, for their family, that they're just very aware of the product that they're purchasing. Raw milk obviously is not pasteurized. There might be some potential concerns with raw milk as opposed to pasteurized milk, and we want to make sure if consumers are making that choice that they have been to the facility. Currently, raw milk, you can purchase raw milk from the farm currently. It can't be delivered. And a big reason for that is so that you as a consumer have been to that facility, met those producers, and know the product that you're buying.
So while you still have to go to the farm to buy raw milk, it will be up to Oklahoma lawmakers whether or not it can be delivered to your door.
Concerned about health and safety and that.
Now, while this does seem to be about consumer convenience, it's also about the ability to advertise the product.
How so?
Well, currently, as the law stands, you cannot advertise your product. So if you're going to find out about it, it has to be by word of mouth, or the farmer can put a sign at the end of the driveway, but you have to drive by it to see it. So if they can advertise the product, they can get more people to buy the milk, and then that'll make it a little bit better in the long run to be able to deliver it if they're allowed.
So what exactly is the opposition to the advertising?
Well, as Mark Newman says, it's more about truth in advertising. What you see on the internet may look beautiful and perfect, but what you get may not be the best thing. And as Blaine Arthur also has a good point, many of the people are removed from the farm by several generations. So if they have to go to the farm, then they get to meet their farmer, they get to see how clean the place is, and they get to see how their milk is produced.
Yeah, well, certainly valid points on both sides of the issue. It'll be an interesting debate down at the legislature. Thanks so much, Elisa.
You're welcome, Rob.